lineup. First for Erie. Defender number 2, Tom Davis. Defender number 13, Sten Markson. Defender number 14, Ryan Lund. Defender number 33, Ricardo Da Silva. Midfielder number 5, Jared Ott. Midfielder number 7, Mitch Kalick. Midfielder number 19, Austin Solomon. Midfielder number 24, Iale Teshager. Forward number 4, Luca Campos. Forward number 11, Danny Deacon. Keeper number 1, Danny Mudd. Erie is coached by Dan Howell. And now your starting lineup for your Cincinnati Saints. Defender number 4, Tony Wiggum. Defender number 5, team captain James Thomas. Defender number 22, Mitch Diley. Defender number 24, Gary Henderson. Midfielder number 9, John Cottrell. Midfielder number 13, Ryan Hanbury. Midfielder number 15, RJ Best. Midfielder number 19, Phil Haggerty. Midfielder number 20, Mark Hansen. Forward number 21, Craig Hurd. And the keeper number 1, Dan Williams. The Saints are coached by David Wall. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise and honor America by removing your hats and directing your attention to the American flag for the playing of our national anthem.
And welcome into ICRC TV's broadcast of the Cincinnati Saints. Today, taking on Erie Commodores.
A little bit of a change from last year.
A little bit of a change. I'm Jerry Lance. That's DJ Schweitzer. Lindsey Patterson down on the touchline. We got not the greatest of weather here, DJ, today.
No, that's right. We've seen quite a bit of rain roll through the Cincinnati area today. Poor Lindsey down on the sidelines having to duck behind a coat, staying dry as best she can down there. So we'll try to keep her appearances limited just so she doesn't have to dance out into the rain. But yeah, the rain seemed to have cleared out over the last half hour or so, which meant the referee said it's a go for tonight.
Yeah, it's go for tonight. There's threat of severe weather in the area, so hopefully we can get this one in without a delay, without the lightning delays that we could possibly see. But DJ, this is a key match for the Saints. They're coming off of a bad stretch. They righted the ship a little bit last week after that devastating loss to Detroit by going on the road to FC Indiana and getting the draw.
That's right. So points on the road are huge in the MPSL. It's always difficult to pick up points on the road. And the Saints did manage that one against a side that they did fairly well against earlier in the season as well. But trying to recover here at home where, as we've talked about many, many times over the 2 years we've been doing the broadcast, picking up points in the MPSL at home is massive. If you drop them, there's really no hope at all of making the playoffs. And reaching the midpoint of the season, the Saints are almost, to a do-or-die portion of the season.
Yeah, things are going to have to pick up for the Saints if they want to have a chance at postseason at all. They're going to have to really just pretty much run the table from this point on.
Yeah, that's right. And it's going to start right here against Erie tonight. Erie sitting a little further north of them in the table, having played a few less games, sitting up in, I believe, seventh place, while the Saints find themselves down in ninth, improving a place from where they were last time we took to the booth.
So Erie will be in the blue with the white socks. Saints, of course, going with the white tops, blue shorts. And we're underway. Saints will be moving left to right here in the first half. Commodores get us underway. They moved to the name the Commodores. They were the Erie Admirals prior to this.
That's right. The Saints have met once before with someone from Erie, last year being the Erie Admirals. It was the beginning of last season. Actually won 3-2 with a darn near end of the game extra time goal.
And here's an opportunity for Erie early. Dan Williams saves it there. That was Danny Deacon coming in hot early. And right away here in the first minute, we'll get a look at that save. We got a corner coming up here that the Saints are going to have to defend.
Yeah, and there's Deacon kind of cutting across, kind of making a run downfield. Got by.
Yeah, back live now.
Yeah.
Ball punched out by Williams. Erie, though, able to maintain possession. Now finally turned over. Saints able to get to this one. It'll be Tony Wiggum. He'll send it over to Gary Henderson, who's able to keep it in.
Gonna
Henderson now.
Going to need to see a little bit more out of Henderson. He's been a big-time player for the Saints in the past. Kind of muted the last couple games. The Saints really expect a lot out of those wingbacks.
Well, and there's a guy we talked about needing back. There's Fel Haggerty there, the pass failing him there as it falls back to Erie. Erie's trying to break out the other way. That's five, Jared Ott. Now Tom Davis, the Kiwi, sending it over. Erie going with a 4-2-2 today. Here's Ott again. We'll just play it back. A long ball up. It'll be Tom Davis trying to get to it, but Henderson does instead. Little tackle there over by the corner flag. This is going to roll. Henderson's going to keep it in, though. It's that last one off of Saints, and now bad pass back there. Thomas having to reel to get that one in. It was Mark Hansen that put him in trouble.
Yeah, you really want to avoid that. But here's R.J. Best.
R.J. Best now coming. And he gets taken out. This will be a free kick coming for the Saints. Is that defender there, number 14, Ryan Lund, got all player on that one. Start it back up here. Now it's Best. Best, he's got Hansen back. It's going to be Craig Hurd as Henderson gets this one here on the near side. Craig Hurd starting up top today.
Yeah, it's been a lot of inconsistency up top for the Saints. We've seen quite a few different players posted up there, probably three or four in the last couple weeks. And here's another long ball. This is something we've seen repetitively out of Erie in the early stages.
Yeah, it's Danny
ball down
Deacon.
The left.
Deacon's got two options in the box now with him. He'll play it out. Tony Wiggum over to cover this. Is now Tom Davis sends it in. Played off a little bit by James Thomas. Ball didn't go far enough. Other players having to come back to clean it up.
And Thomas, a bit of a pregame worry. He's been battling some groin injuries for a majority of the season pulling something early on. Actually, the last preseason match of the year was a pre-match concern, but actually got the call today.
Yeah, a little bit of an issue that pulled up last night in practice with his back. A little bit of tightness there. So it was a concern if he was going to start. If not, there are some injuries on that back line. So it was going to be Ryan Hanbury dropping back from that holding mid position.
Yeah, but luckily Thomas was able to make the start tonight, and Hanbury pushes up into his normal midfield position.
Yeah, talking to him right before the game, I said, "You starting?" He goes, "I'm starting." I was like, "Are you good to go?" And he goes, "We'll find out."
Always a concern when you're captain and captain of your back line, even for that matter.
But as a captain, I guess you want to be out there with your team as much as you possibly can. As this ball from Tom Davis rolls back.
Saints not really applying a whole lot of pressure.
Not
in the
a ton
early
of
stages.
Pressure. Shager now. Going to play this all the way up. This is going to be an onside ball. Dan Williams gets to it there.
Yeah, great little pressure from James Thomas. It looked like he'd been caught out on that long ball, something we're seeing repetitively from the Erie side. They're clearly going to play that route one, look for the counterattack to try to get behind what's clearly a little bit of a knackered Saints back line. Tony Wiggum back there again today as well. He's about to see the ball played past him, seeing a little bit of injury concerns as well this season.
Yeah, playing ahead of Drew Midkiff, who is going to be out for a couple weeks. Had to have a surgery on a cyst earlier this week, so he'll be out for possibly a few matches, definitely this weekend, though. So this ball go out. It'll be Erie's ball. Erie really just not feeling the pressure there on that back line, just moving it around. There's Ott now with the pass.
Yeah, Erie really controlling the flow in the early stages, be it through the counterattacks or in possession.
Erie still with the ball. Good pass over, and this ball comes in. Thomas gets it again, but not enough, and it's cleared straight in for a shot.
It's two kind of fluffed clearances now by Thomas. We saw one a couple minutes ago.
Yeah.
Wondering if that back's still giving him a little bit of trouble.
Yeah, not being able to really put a whole lot into these clearances, really just not playing the ball well at all. Erie, though, back on the possession. Play it up now. Again, no pressure as they just able to move it back and forth between their defenders.
Yeah, Saints really not picking up at all the pressure until they're about 5 yards from their own half.
Here comes that long ball again. This one will fall to Tony Wiggum. He'll have to clear it somewhat dangerously over to Henderson. Henderson playing up to Hansen. Hansen flicks over to Cottrell. Back to Hurd. Up to Hansen. Hansen's got the wheels if he can get to this one. It's going to be a race there with Tom Davis. And ultimately, it's Tom Davis getting to that one, the New Zealander.
Yeah, a little too heavy of a touch from Hansen on that break there. But nice build-up play from the Saints. Find themselves a little bit of a pressure. Work themselves out of the corner, and we're able to find a decent look on a counterattack.
Here's that deep ball from Ott, but Lucas Campos plays it out. Throw-in coming for the Saints. It'll be Henderson taking this one. Over to Cottrell. Cottrell fighting for it, the Englishman. Fighting with Jared Ott. Ott winning that one. Back over to Campos. Cottrell will play it out.
Kind of contrary to what the Saints are doing, that Commodore's actually pressuring way high up on the field at the moment, trying to cough possession out of the Saints early on and try to, you know, minimize the amount of space they need to counter into. Here's that long ball
Ball from Lund. It's going to get to Tony Wiggum. He's going to try to usher this out.
Luca Campo is putting him under tons of pressure, and you can see just how high the Commodores are actually pressing.
Dan Williams will have this for a goal kick.
Saints really struggle to hold any sort of possession in the early running. As soon as they get it, they're either, you know, looking for the counter themselves or coughing it up. Really need to just calm down, take some touches, don't force yourselves. Kind of like what we're seeing here.
Yeah, good play here. The back line just kind of sets themselves up to Cottrell.
Kind of first touch of the game from Cottrell.
Yeah, he's not seen it much. Cottrell, one of two players along with Henderson, who had just played the ball to him. Those are the only two that have started in every match so far, and that streak continues today. Diley playing it up there. Now it's Best. Best is going to try a long ball here to Mark Hansen. Hansen might be able to get to this one, but he might run out of room, and he does.
Like the idea from the switch of attack from R.J. Best there. Obviously, the cross a little wanting, but Saints still struggling to hold on to that ball, really not finding many opportunities. Not seeing a whole lot of movement up top at the moment either. I think that's stifling a bit of the attack.
It's Erie back on the ball. We'll just move it around. A few white jerseys finally made it up to kind of get in the faces of that back line. Now Hanbury. He's going to try to find it. He's going to try to find Hurd. Tom Davis able to get to it. And the ball ushered in over by Ricardo da Silva. Portuguese player on that back line. It's now Ott. Now to Silva. Erie really still feeling pretty comfortable on the ball.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll play this up. And now they got a great opportunity here.
Smart.
Real dangerous move here. And it could be a ball falling for an Erie player, but ultimately doesn't.
Great little,
Dan Williams getting to it.
Great little touch from the Commodores' Danny Deacon to actually set that counterattack free. Caught the Saints' back line totally off guard.
Yeah, and it was Deacon who almost had a chance to put that one back in. Now Cottrell.
So it looks like up top, Deacon and Campos kind of the main targets in the early running for the Commodores.
Yeah, they've been finding the ball plenty so far in the opening 10 minutes. Hansen back to Cottrell. And then Hurd's going to flick it over for Mark Hansen. The Swede, who played at Fairfield High School, loses possession there to number 19, which we actually don't have a 19. They didn't give us one.
No.
Erie stays with it. Shager. Now to Silva. A lot of players on this side here, including keeper Mudd here, as this falls to the Saints' back line. Tony Williams got it. A lot of Mercyhurst players
on
this Erie side.
Yeah, close to half the roster actually made up of Mercyhurst players themselves. A little bit of an international contingent as well. We've seen mainly domestic opponents so far for the Saints this year.
That ball falls out of play there. Looked like they were going to say that Hurd was onside. That would have been a decent play there had it stayed in.
Yeah.
Instead, it falls back to Erie. 12th minute of play here. It's mainly been Erie. No score yet. But a couple chances already. Flag goes up for offside. Campos getting called there.
Mm-hmm. So, again, that direct play from Erie. Still concerning for the Saints getting that offside call there to help them out.
Yeah, they were caught once again. I mean, it was offside, but it wasn't offside by much.
No.
Here's Best now on the far side. Try to get over to no avail. Erie back on the ball. They're staying with it.
Unfortunate call there for the Saints. It looked like the winger.
Yeah, the Erie player going down there on the far side.
And you'll see a replay of it here. Little bit of hand grabbing over here, but he kind of just stepped on top of the ball. Ironically, that's not what the call was for. You didn't actually catch
it. Yeah, it was
much
advantage
of the,
play.
Hand-to-hand
there.
Combat there. So pretty quiet opening quarter hour here. Saints still finding themselves the passengers of the match so far, as the Commodores have kind of dictated things.
Dan Mudd there touching the ball pretty much for one of the first times there. He has not been called into action yet from the Saints' attack. Here comes Erie the other way. Cutting over. James Thomas clearing it out. Able to get a little better boot on it, but falls right to one of his players luckily, and now Hanbury and Diley trying to clean things up.
Gary Henderson finally with some space in front of him.
A little bit of space, but really he had no one to send it up to.
No.
Now Haggerty. Haggerty back from injury. 3 goals on the season. That ties him with Montoya at the top for the Saints. Back to Thomas, who's just going to probably decide not to take that long ball chance.
No.
Because it's possibly may cost him a couple minutes to do that. He is dealing with some back injuries, some groin injuries. That's what happens late on in your career, I guess.
Yeah, that's right. Get on in years. Body doesn't quite respond to
you. Don't know anything about that.
No,
do you?
No, not whatsoever. I have not been getting injured in any of my amateur games recently. You get on in years and your body just isn't able to take the wear and tear, the rigor of a long season. Here we're seeing a foul from the Saints, clear as day.
Yeah, right there in front of the official there. So free kick taken quickly. And it's Ricardo Silva sending this up. Tom Davis. Davis trying to get around Henderson. He doesn't. Henderson trying to keep this ball in play. And now Henderson playing it up, and Tom Davis able to get to it, trying to get around his man there. Davis painted into a corner now. He's got 2 Saints players on him, Henderson and Hansen. He'll have to bail it out. And now you have Haggerty coming back to kind of help.
Great
on the defense there.
Great work by Erie, though, to maintain possession in that kind of situation.
And a direct shot in. That's really not going to trouble Dan Williams. Williams will send this ball up. Trying to find Hurd. He'll be offside, though. So Dan Williams, after this season, he will go join the U.S. national team 7-a-side squad as they begin training for their world championship.
Yeah.
Back underway here. Ball played up again. That long ball taken down by Thomas originally, and now Cottrell's going to try to return the favor, sending this up. Caught an Erie player.
And Hurd's just on an island by himself up
there. Yeah, he's not really been able to touch the ball much at all.
Erie, plenty of time still to make decisions. Not a whole lot of pressure when they're holding onto the ball.
Here comes that deep ball. Thomas going to get under it. Cottrell moving in there to get to it. Hansen trying to flick it up to somebody, but
referee waves off the foul. Good step there.
A great little pickoff there.
From Diley.
Diley, he's going to try to send it up. It goes off an Erie player. Just like that. Saints try to make a move, but it's Erie being able to get back on the ball quickly. Is now Thomas playing it up to Campos. He's got Deacon on the far end. It'll fall to a Saints player. It's Hanbury. He's going to play this out, and he continues with it.
And credit Hanbury, good play there, but it's a little nerve-wracking to see your center midfielder all late tackle in there.
Yeah, real late tackle.
Love to see the referee give the Erie play a little bit of a warning there.
Yeah, didn't
tackle
really
like that, breaks up an attack. Not only that, but from behind.
Yeah,
let him know, hey,
there.
No more of that.
Now it's Diley. What a Best. Best is, this ball is going to be played up from Hurd. It was Diley on the overlapping run, but he just could not get there in time.
Yeah, Hurd's touch just a little wanting as well. Tried to play that as a flick through on, and luckily he's won back possession.
Hurd with it now. He scored the equalizer against FC Indiana. 47th minute penalty that he earned and then converted.
And here's the problem we've seen a lot out of the Saints this season. Just stagnation up front when they're actually in possession in attack.
Yeah, they said talking to Jamie Starr before the match, and he said Hurd was brought in to start over Montoya, who's got the goals, because they feel like he gives them a little more movement. But you're seeing tonight, so far, that movement really hasn't been there.
Yeah, you get one run, and then you aren't rewarded with that run, and ultimately the player just quits, and we need to see a little bit more of that keep moving, even if you don't see that first pass. It's going to open up spaces. It's going to leave room for other players to attack or potentially even yourself.
Hansen fighting for it now as it's the Saints once again, kind of on their back heels, trying to make sure no one slips behind them.
Yeah, so you can see this Mitch Kavlik going in here and winning the ball for Erie.
Yeah, here comes Kavlik.
And it was kind of a bit of a shoulder charge on his front.
It almost looked like he stumbled kind of into him, though.
Mm-hmm.
Back underway now. It's James Thomas, the captain, just feeding it off to Wigan. Now Hanbury. They're just going to try to matriculate this ball up the field.
Someone's been reading the dictionary.
Well, matriculate. That's a good old term that American football broadcasters always like to shoehorn into broadcasts. I figure I can join that.
Bring it.
Tried to play it up there to find Hurd, and once again, it's Ricardo Silva. Ricardo Silva on the end of that one.
Maybe starting to see a little bit what the Saints are trying to do there. We saw Hansen trying to find Hurd's head, maybe a flick on for the overlap. Just not quite working out for the Saints.
Yeah, whistle there. Free kick to Erie. They take it quickly. Saints bench wasn't really happy with how easy that call came.
With that call, we're seeing a few players on the Saints bench actually get up to warm up.
Yeah, you see David Glant, Justin Smith, Jared Huber, and Luke Maitland all hopping off that bench. Erie, though, still with the ball. Now it's number 19, the mystery man. He's going to play it up.
Really like that run from the mystery man here in the
back
corner.
Back onto him here.
Solid tackle in from Henderson.
Yeah, Henderson doing a good job. Get the ball. And it looks like they actually won the ball. They'll have the throw in. The official talking to that mystery man.
If we have any Aerie fans tuning in to tonight's broadcast,
please let us know.
Let us know. Tweet at us at Wrong Side of Pond, at Jeremy Lance.
We're just going off the information we were given. And there is a 19 on the team, but not on the dress list we were given, so. Gary Henderson now. Tough challenge there. He stays with it. Ultimately off of, I believe, Mark Hansen, and quick throw in there by the Kiwi. Tom Davis plays it back. Auckland native. He'll send it to his back line there.
Yeah, Davis, big man for a left back. Tidy with the ball, though.
He's been. You've seen him dart up the field plenty so far in this first half.
Yeah, that's right. We saw him with that long possession holding on to it down in the corner when Erie countered just a few moments ago. Not afraid with the ball at his feet.
Another long ball over. This will fall to Campos. And that goes wide of both the goal and a diving Dan Williams.
So Erie with most of the good looks so far. Saints really haven't put anything coherent together in attack so far.
No, they haven't. They haven't done anything. No shots on goal. No shots at all for the Saints.
RJ Best making his way over, getting some instruction from Coach Wall.
Yeah, Coach Wall trying to – he's clearly seeing something he either wants to exploit or he wants the Saints to fix. As Best runs back there. Heard there, fighting for it, winning it. It'll roll back to Haggerty.
Yeah, referee rightly looked to see if the Saints were going to gain any possession out of that. Wisely calls it back.
Yeah, didn't see the advantage coming, so free kick here.
Like to see the Saints. Saints. Just really no ambition at all to get themselves up into the box.
Here comes Cottrell.
Just not hit hard enough or high enough.
An Erie player there. Stan Markham.
And we got a tweet in here. It appears it's Austin Solomon, who is our mystery man. Thanks very much to Billy Colton at 10_BFC.
Thank you, sir.
Appreciate that, Austin Solomon, being identified
Austin
as
Solomon.
Our number 19.
Well, he's been playing well, so I'm sure he'll appreciate it. It's Tom Davis now with the ball. Back to DeSilva, and he'll just roll this back. It's Dan Mudd. But one of the names that definitely sticks out that was on this side last year came up for the – it was the Saints.
Ooh,
NPSL opener,
there.
Their first NPSL home match. They won it. Eric Nock converting the penalty late for a 2-1 win.
It was actually our first match in the broadcast booth.
Yes, it was. So here's Erie. They have options. Play it off to Ott. Ott's just going to take a shot. Started to curve in on that corner there.
Yeah, I think that was a great save there from Dan Williams.
Yeah, Dan
Full
Williams
stretch was able to palm it wide of that far post. I think it was going to curl inside. Good look from the Erie Commodores attack.
Corner kick coming for Erie. They had a couple right at the beginning of the match. And now they have another one here in the 24th minute. Swings in right to Dan Williams, who's able to take care of that one.
He looks to roll quick. Just no one in attack, really, for the Saints to break
to
right away.
Yeah, no one
ready
to. Finally gets it over to Hurd. He's got Henderson on the overlap here. He's going to try to play it to him. Henderson, probably the fastest guy on the team, but even he's not going to be fast enough to get to that one.
And Austin Solomon had it covered without question anyway.
Tom Davis. Going to throw this one in.
Rain so far, holding off.
Holding off, yeah, I see a little bit. But it is starting to get a bit darker.
Mm-hmm.
As the storm system continues to move through the tri-state area. We headed right back to Mudd. Trying to get his guys to get upfield. 25th minute of play. And it's been mostly Erie. They're probably going to want to see something on that score sheet, though. For all the effort they're putting in.
That's right.
Back to Solomon.
Solomon, big, strong play there.
Yeah, good job to muscle his defender off the ball. But this is going to fall. Hurd's going to get it. I think Haggerty wanted it. He was kind of making the run onto the ball. This go to Best. He'll flick it on there. It's not going to find Haggerty. And that goes off of Best as well. Kept in from by Diley. Hanbury playing it back to Diley. Mitch Diley sending it over to James Thomas.
Better from the Saints here.
Yeah, good little run of possession. Probably their best so far, easily. Not a lot to choose from, though. Mark Hansen trying to keep this one in. He's got Hurd. He's going to try to get it, too, but the Englishman could not get there in time.
Yeah, like
picked
that.
Off and back the other way it goes. It's going to be the deep ball again. Danny Deacon trying to get to it as Thomas chests the ball, and Wiggum has to kick it away.
Yeah, I'm really liking what I'm liking now that we've identified Austin Solomon. He's been quite good for the Commodores. Wins the ball back in possession, moves quickly off the ball, puts himself in good spots to assist his teammates.
Deacon now with the long ball. This is going to find a boot. Finally cleared out by Wiggum.
Great diagonal there from Deacon as well.
Yeah, he's another one that's been doing a good job is on the throw in here. You have Dan Williams barking out orders to his back line. He's not liking this last little minute here where Commodores have had a couple opportunities. They stay with the ball here. You see the deep ball almost getting played there. Now here comes the cross in. Goes off of the fingers of Williams. It's Mark Hansen there to clean it up, and he gives it to Hanbury, who has to spin around and keep moving as he's trying to find someone to play it up to, and finally he'll send it all the way out to Diley out on the far side there.
And there's just quite the gap between
Best
the midfield and the strikers there.
Yeah, come all the way back to get that ball.
Cottrell just kind of playing even with Hanbury, not getting a whole lot of depth out of that midfield in the middle, not really putting together any triangles, any kind of looks for them to work the ball between.
Yeah, there you see Henderson had a bunch of time there, looked up to try to get it to somebody, and he just could not see anything that appealed to him.
Yeah, the Saints really have their wings spread pretty wide. Hansen, R.J. Best, almost out on the touch lines in almost every possession. And it's leaving up top Hurd to basically control a space with three or four men all by himself. And
he's
just not leaving a whole lot of outlets for the Saints.
He's been almost non-existent tonight. It's a nice little run of play here. It's Henderson off of Hansen. He'll have to keep possession to fight on this one. And it'll be in to Shager. Stealing it back, and now here comes that long ball again, and it's Danny Deacon. He's onside. Thomas able to kind of bump the ball off of him, and he'll just have to send this. Well, he's going to send it out, but Mark Hansen gets back to keep it in. Hansen there, under a lot of pressure. Saints, as they're kind of pinned back right now. Hansen goes down in a heap. Tom Davis, a little shove from Davis. He's going to get a card, probably. The card is in the hand of the ref. And there it is, Tom Davis.
No, really no need there.
Generally,
from Davis.
From New Zealand are pretty even keel.
Yeah, and you can see a replay of that here where Davis just went in a little too strong.
Yeah, went in strong. And then he was kind of pulled there.
Yeah, you can
by
see.
Hansen. He goes down, and then
here comes the shove.
Yeah, and then you just see him just shoving.
Hansen lucky not to get a card himself there. He came and gave Davis a little bit of a kick on the way down.
So, Gary Henderson here on the restart. 29th minute of play here. Send it into the middle.
Not unusual for things to get a little physical here in the MPSL.
Good little flick on, but no one there.
Almost a bit of mix-up there
from
the Saints.
Yeah, mix-up there with Wiggum and Henderson. With two area players there, both Campos and Deacon, they could not be making those mistakes. And now Hanbury actually just has to send it all the way back to Williams. Now Henderson. Henderson and Hansen trying to get some link-up play going tonight on that near side, but just the inconsistency of the possession. It's just not left them with a whole lot to work with.
No, it's not just inconsistency in possession. It's inconsistencies in the squad. We've seen a lot of turnover from the Saints and not quite the same lineup for a lot of the matches.
Here's a great opportunity. It's Wiggum back fighting. Actually, it's Best. Best had moved all the way back to track that one, and he's still fighting with it.
Great recovery from
Best. Yeah, great shot. And then Hanbury having to step in front of what would have been a great opportunity by Erie. Ball goes off. Erie player throw in here for the Saints. I think we're starting to see a few little sprinkles here and there. Saints again kind of have to play it over. Here's Wiggum. Send it over to Thomas, who at this point we can confirm he will not be the one booting it downfield tonight. Hansen lays it off for Henderson.
Saints have grown into this match as we've kind of worn on a little bit. Still not quite finding those attacks.
Hanbury. This may find Hurd. He'll fight for it, and he sticks with it, and he's got the ball. No one really moving up. He'll have to send it all the way across to Haggerty.
Not
cleaned out there.
And the referee did call his whistle. I was a little concerned he wasn't going to let it go, but unfortunately for the Erie protestations there, and we can see a replay of that here in just a moment.
Yeah, Mitch Cavlett coming in there and just taking Phil out.
And Haggerty just managed to get there just a step beforehand. And
yeah, stepping in front of that ball.
Well, it was a 50-50 chance, unfortunately, because Haggerty beat him to it. That's why we saw the call fouled.
So free kick here. This is really, you got to say, this is at this point, given where it's at, easily the best opportunity for the Saints tonight.
Yeah. You can imagine we're going to see a shot here from the Saints. Yeah, really like no one up on the you know, for a service like in.
Diley and Hanbury kind of talking about it. Now it's going to be Haggerty. See? Almost falls over Cottrell. So it looks like it'll be Haggerty. Haggerty takes it straight on.
Decent look.
Decent ball, but just did not get the dip he wanted there at the end.
A little too much power, not quite enough spin.
Yeah, ends up missing top of the goal by about 2-3 feet.
Unfortunately for the Saints, that's the best of the attacks we've
seen
from
them so far.
Yeah, I
mean, that's the best they've done so far. That's really their only shot tonight was right there.
Unfortunately, none yet on target.
Coach Howell just giving a little instruction there to Tom Davis. Currently sitting on a yellow. As this ball comes in, Hanbury plays it up.
Coach Howell, a former player of Erie, not necessarily the Commodore generation, but while they were the Admirals, also a former player at Mercyhurst himself.
We got a player down here for Erie. He looked like he grabbed, I don't know if he thought he caught an elbow or what. It's going to be a free kick.
Yeah, still holding his face. Referee stopping play. Can't quite tell if he's grabbing at his eye, maybe grabbing at his mouth.
Yeah, I don't know if he thought he got something.
And he's got some blood on his hand there.
Yeah.
So the referee's asking him to have to come off, get that cleaned up at bare minimum.
So, well, it'll be a free kick here to Erie. Jared Ott stands over it right now. So get him some water there. I believe that was Austin Solomon that's getting some treatment now, trying to wash his mouth out, or is looking like he's maybe washing his face out. Free kick, though, as we're back underway. Immediately picked off by the Saints. Hanbury with it. The Englishman's got some options. He'll play it out to Best. Best back to Diley. Now Wiggum's going to have to run and track this ball back. Now Thomas with it. He'll just play it up. Now Henderson looked up again. Looked up for that long ball opportunity, just didn't see it. Now, the opportunity did come from Cottrell, but that ball going out, thrown for Erie. Saints being a bit wasteful there. Their long balls have not connected really at all tonight.
Well, not many of their balls have connected, period, tonight. Saints struggling to get that attack building.
Here's Hanbury, just one-man wrecking crew to win that ball back, but it eventually just falls a little too far. So he tried to, I think, play in Hurd there. Wiggum fighting for that one. With Campos. Campos winning this one. Lucas Campos, he's going to flick it forward. Dan Williams should be able to get there, and he does. 35th minute of play here as we begin to wind down this first half. So far, nothing cooking for the Saints. Erie, though, they've had some opportunities. They just haven't cashed him in. It's here goes long ball again. It's Lucas Campos. He'll get on the end of this one. He didn't have anyone to play it to, and Wiggum had time to steal it back. He sends it up. Hansen tried to flick it on. Thought Hurd was a little closer to him, but instead it was Austin Solomon.
Yeah, it's just those little mistakes from the Saints that are really punishing them. Little mistouches, miscues on passes, not putting it to people's feet, not necessarily even hustling in some circumstances. It leaves the Saints in just some position where they're chasing the ball like they have for most of the game.
Haggerty almost trying to get in front of that one there. Nearly did. So the ball goes pinging back and lands to Tom Davis. Just nutmegged Mark Hansen right there. He's off to the races. Saints getting in the way of this one, and now Hanbury goes down.
Pretty unfortunate call there. I think Davis actually had won the ball.
Yeah, the Hanbury kind of late to that party, but he's the one that goes down and earns the call there.
Theatrics sometimes help out, and you're going to see a replay of that tackle here in just a moment. And Davis, I think, clearly to the ball first, was cleanly down, and Hanbury just kind of went down with a little extra in it.
Hanbury back on the ball now, sends it over to Thomas. We'll just roll it back to Dan Williams. Boston Natum will send this all the way up to the midfield here. Falls down again, finding blue shirts, not white shirts so far. Now Hanbury firing this forward. Best maybe onside
on this
one.
Great ball through.
Fires it in and just wide.
Oh, and there's our best opportunity for the Saints so far.
A fantastic opportunity by Best. A great ball played in from Hanbury, but ultimately just not being able to cash in. We'll get the replay here.
Just a perfectly weighted ball over from Ryan Hanbury. And Best effort just wide of that far post. Would have liked to see him use that right foot to try to curve it into that far side.
Would have been a really... really great opportunity for the Saints against the run of play to steal a goal here.
Yeah, it just kind of came out of nowhere.
Of the first half.
Can't say enough about that Hanbury through ball, though.
Oh, amazing ball there coming not only that far up the field, but it crossed a good bit of distance from side to side on the pitch as well. So here's Henderson fighting for it. A little bit of shirt grabbing there by Campos. So it'll be a free kick here for Henderson.
Henderson's starting to feel a little groove a bit there. Some fancy footwork of his own to hold on to possession. Was by his man. Took that tug to pull back. Thwart the attack.
Up to Hurd here.
Saints starting to find some confidence after that little build-up.
Now it's Hanbury again. Does he have another one in him? He's going to try. Try to get up to Hansen, but Hansen couldn't get over there for that ball. And now it's Best fighting for this one. He wins it. He'll send this all the way. He'll send it actually to Cottrell. Now Hanbury. Over to Diley. Which Diley back to Cottrell. Trying to flick it. I think he thought Hanbury was a little closer to him. And Saints lose possession on that one.
And there's Solomon again on the ball, winning
it
back.
All over the place. This will roll forward. Tom Davis onto it. Now Campos. Picked out there by Henderson. He gets it away. Still fighting for it with Davis. And he keeps it in.
Great little back heel
now
there.
Luke Campos with it. He'll play it over. Shager over to Davis. Davis fighting for it. He had two on him. And it'll just be a goal kick. I thought he would have tried to get a little bit of contact, a little bit of deflection as he sent that ball across. Instead, this will just be played up nicely to Ryan Hanbury.
Yeah, it looked like he just caught a little bit of the turf before he played that ball in. That's probably why we saw him kind of fluff the cross.
Now Diley, kind of putting the foot on it. Sending it back there. Thomas with it. Thomas will just play it up. We know he's not going to go for the deep ball.
There's Hanbury again.
Ryan Hanbury will. He'll send this up. It'll be Best. He's going to try to fight for this one. Just has to head it onto the keeper. Best goes for it. Best with the shot, and it's in. It's going to be possibly an own goal as it's ultimately kicked in. But it's R.J. Best getting on the board in the 39th minute.
Yeah, and that was just hustle from R.J. Best, putting that pressure, and we're going to look
sticking
at
sticking with that ball, yeah.
And we're going to see the replay here, and you can just kind of see goalkeeper kind of slow to come out. The defender calling back for him. Kind of poor header back. And Best just stuck with it, was able to win through. And we can see the defender try to put another clearance in.
But that
in.
Was going in anyways.
Yeah.
So that'd be 39th minute. We'll credit that one to Best. Because that was going in. Ultimately kicked in on an open net by the defender.
So a break for the Saints. Still against the run of play. You're going to see a little more impetus out of Erie as they try to even this deficit with just a couple minutes left before half.
win a little bit of momentum back as we close out this first half here. 40th minute of play. Cottrell, so just roll it back to Thomas. And Thomas there finally with a long ball. And if almost flick in, and that's going to be handball called. It's a great little play on the overlap, trying to get it to Diley. Best, that's his first goal in the NPSL season. He scored in the friendly in that second leg against Cleveland. Obviously, that didn't count. It wasn't part of an actual NPSL-sanctioned match. So that is officially his first one of the season.
That's right. So Best, been a big contributor this year, brought a lot to the team. Two assists on the season. Really has been dynamic, both in attack, playing on the wing, holding on to possession, and as we've seen a couple times tonight, even making recovery runs back in defense.
Here's Ott with it.
So what we have to worry about for the Saints here is that they don't sit back on their laurels. We've seen them take leads several times this season and cough up quite a few even here at home.
Yeah, no letdown. Coach Wall talked about it after that Detroit match. They have to learn how to close these things out. They didn't do it against Detroit. That ball rolls under Tony Wiggum. Dan Williams able to take care of it, but a little sloppiness there that could have been dangerous. This will fall to Henderson. He's going to send it up here to Mark Hansen. Over to Hurd. Now Hansen. Sending it back to Henderson. He'll play it over to Cottrell. Cottrell a little heavy on the touch. We'll have to go back for it. Thomas with it. Thomas looking. Probably not the deep ball again. So it'll just go up to Cottrell. Now Thomas with it. He'll send this all the way over to Wiggum, who's covering that far side there. Calling for a little help there.
This is where the Saints just get into trouble. They work it just about up to midfield, and then we just kind of see things stagnate. Not a whole lot of movement up top. One or two men maybe moving, but just not enough.
There.
Especially as we see Erie collapse back.
Yeah, Erie getting the ball back there as Hansen was offside. Erie moving forward. He'll send that long one. That'll go nowhere.
So if this is your first time tuning in to a Saints broadcast, Jeremy and I actually are from a website, wrongsideofthepond.com. Give us a check out. Based out of here in Cincinnati, we have a blog, a podcast that we do weekly. Although the summers, we take a break
a little bit of break because we're doing this.
Yeah, that's right. Also, check it out. We got a national pub directory. We probably have one in your town, and there are some in Erie. So give that a look, wrongsideofthepond.com. You can find us on Twitter, wrongsideofpond.
Phil Haggerty is down. And he's still down, kind of rolling around. He took a knock a couple weeks ago on an ankle. Hopefully it's not that same one, as he is still in some pain there.
Yeah, he's kind of looking in some agony, rolling around.
Play continues, though. It's to Shagger.
He's gotten up once. He looks like he's kind of getting up again.
Finally staggering here, but it's Erie on the attack. They'll shoot it in. Off the legs, comes back in. Back to Williams.
Nearly looked in.
Nearly looked in from this angle, but hit off the outside of the post there. It'll just be a goal kick here for Dan Williams. Real good opportunity for Erie, though, there. Saints cannot let up. It's burned them before. It's burned them a week ago. And probably some of the most horrific fashion. That Detroit game will probably sit with them for a little bit. And hopefully they'll learn from that as far as closing out matches.
Because
if there is a textbook definition of how not to close out a match, when you're a man up, that would be it.
Yeah, if you tuned in with us last week or didn't tune in with us last week, the Saints, with a man advantage and a goal in the last 20 minutes, conceded three to end up losing here.
Conceded three in the last 11 minutes.
Yeah, ended up losing here at Angus King Stadium at Withrow High School. Just not the type of collapse you like to see, especially after last year seeing Detroit pip a late win as well.
Hanbury. A little fancy footwork to get around his countrymen there. Now over to Diley. Diley play back to Wiggum. Forty-fourth minute of play here. This ball is going to be sent all the way back to Dan Williams, who's up out of his box. He's going to send this up here. And instead finds Ricardo Da Silva instead of Hurd. Fighting for it is Haggerty. Haggerty's not giving up on this ball. Hansen comes in, but they're able to get it out to Davis. Now here comes the long ball. Gets to Campos. Campos has this. He'll have an opportunity, not a great one. Dan Williams able to take care of that. neatly.
Yeah, so we've seen quite a few of those counter looks, those direct balls, route one from Erie, as they try to get those counters through.
Well, we had a yellow card, an injury, and a goal. We're about ready to hit it. DJ, how much stoppage time do you believe we're going to have here? We're in the 45th minute of play here, and that clock's about ready to stop moving.
Yeah, looks like I just saw the fourth official. Luckily, as you were asking for a prediction, I saw him show that we're only going to have 1 minute of added time.
And this
not
goes
really
up,
surprising.
This goes up to Danny Deacon. He'll play it over. Wiggum getting in front of it. And another great opportunity there by Erie. Goes for naught. Cottrell. So we are into stoppage time. You said it was just going to be a minute. We're going to probably move to that minute here pretty quickly. Saints can just sit on this ball and take it to halftime. Diley moving kind of forward here. Over to Hanbury, who just play it on now to Henderson. You don't want to see them give up here in the last second, but you don't want to see them cough up something stupid here.
And imagine that'll be just enough.
Yeah, when he don't know if they'll be able to get this up the pitch.
Referee gives his wrist a little bit of a look.
This goes off of Thomas. He couldn't fully get to it. Now tries to flick it forward. Tom Davis able to get to it instead.
Heavy touch there from
Thomas.
And now
Solomon over to Davis. This might be one last opportunity here. And maybe it's not, as Gary Henderson gets to it first.
And they're going to give him one more look from this throw-in. Davis opts to go short.
Yep. Go to Solomon. Solomon gets around. Cleaned out there. No call by the ref.
Really lucky call there for Henderson, too.
Goal kick is all he's
Solomon
saying.
Was able to squirt by him there on the near line.
I mean,
definitely
we didn't
by
have
him.
The angle to see it if he got the ball or not.
I definitely had the angle, and I'll tell you what. Henderson got nothing but man right here.
Absolutely. Definitely catching that right leg.
Not a penalty call. It was just outside the box. So the Saints get lucky there a little bit.
They survive, but maybe not for long. Play in here to Deacon. Deacon will turn around. He'll take a shot. Williams will watch this. And there is your whistle. We'll go to halftime. Saints up 1-0. Lindsay Patterson on the touchline. She'll try to get a word with Coach Wall here. Lindsay, take it away. And it looks like you don't got Lindsay's mic working at the moment there. Maybe took on a little bit of water.
Yeah, it's possible.
Got to think Coach Wall a little happy with the fact that they are actually on the better footing at this point after a half a play where they really didn't look the better side.
No, Erie definitely had the Saints on the back foot for a majority of the first half. Kind of glimpses every once in a while what the Saints are trying to do, but again, that attack is so stagnant, not getting a whole lot of movement, especially in the higher portions of midfield. So we're going to need to see more out of that if the Saints expect to not to cough up another lead here in Cincinnati.
Well, that's it. We'll go to the half. Saints with the lead, 1-0. We'll be back with the second half after this. Get ready to get back underway here for the second half. A little rain, lightning delay, I guess it was. Kept us off the pitch for about an extra 30 minutes or so. So we're back underway. It'll be the Saints quickly, and they're looking to move right away, as they'll be moving right to left on the screen in the second half here. They stay with the ball here. That was Hurd staying with it, eventually coughing it up. Thomas. Try to send it back up, but it'll just go out. And Erie with the throw in here.
Yeah, so it's going to be tough with the long layoff.
Long layoff, a wet turf at the moment.
Yeah, it's going to be tough with that long layoff, making sure you stay fresh. You're going to have to be worried about guys, especially the older ones and guys who are carrying injuries like Thomas. Maybe getting some cold muscles out there. So it's going to be important for the Saints to make sure that they're not putting themselves in bad spots earlier on and stretching themselves a little too early before they have a chance to get warmed up again.
So if you're the Saints, I guess there's no better way to finish off a game than to just go ahead and extend that lead.
Yep.
You got to figure they need to look for that goal.
Yep.
Early here.
You can see they're trying to come out of the gates a little bit on fire, really pushing here in the early
stages.
Yeah,
I think I heard even James Thomas, right as they were getting ready to go, saying, guys, right away. So throw in here for Diley. We played out. Another throw in here coming for the Saints. Saints took the lead in the 39th minute off of R.J. Best, winning a failed header back to the keeper and getting around him, putting it in. It actually ended up going in for what would be an own goal, but it was a clear shot on an empty target. So
yeah, I think
you got to give the credit to R.J. Best on that one.
Yeah, it's definitely Best's goal. You know, the hustle and the determination he showed there to actually make that goal happen at bare minimum is reason enough to get him to him. But I think that shot was going in, and that's reason enough not to give it an own goal for the Erie defender.
As Hanbury tries to play it back up. Erie with it now. It's Austin Solomon fighting for it and fought a little too much here. So we had some rain. We had some lightning. There's a little bit of wind.
Yeah, the wind's picked
blowing
up.
Around now, yeah, as this system continues to move through. It'll be Cottrell over to Diley here. Diley with it now.
There is a little bit of a late tackle.
Yeah, late tackle from behind.
Didn't get any of the ball there, number 5, Jared Ott. We're going to see a replay of that here. And he went down for that tackle and just clearly caught nothing but foot there on Diley. You'll see him make a protest here right at the end saying he got the ball, but nothing in that one.
See, he's talking here with the ref. No card. So it'll be free kick here. Cottrell takes it. Tried to catch Erie off guard, but misplayed that ball, and now it's Erie moving back the other way.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a wasted chance there. You want to see them hold on to possession, especially when you get a free kick that far down the pitch.
Played out by Thomas, so it'll be a throw in here for Erie as they move men upfield. Weren't aware of any halftime changes that we saw.
No, haven't seen any.
If we pick any out, we'll let you know.
A full complement of Erie Commodores up training on the near touchline right now.
Kavalik taking this in. He'll cross this over.
Dangerous ball.
Looked like it almost went out of play.
And it eventually
And they
does.
Did. They said that it did go out on its way over to the other side of the goal. So
Saints a little bit napping on that backside, though. No one really even thought that ball was going to stay in play and could have left themselves in a dangerous spot had it actually not trickled over the end line.
Dan Williams lets guys get set up here before he boots this one down. He'll send it here into the middle of the field. Mark Hansen got to it. He'll flick it in for Hurd. Hurd's chasing. As he go back to Mudd, he'll just clear it out. Hansen again with it. This time it's Phil Haggerty. Great shot, and that'll be cleaned up by Hurd.
What a chance that was from distance.
Haggerty with a great shot there to start that.
And that's exactly what you're going to want to see on a surface like this. After that rain comes through, and we're going to get a replay of that right here, you want to see those players taking shots from distance, getting them on frame.
Yeah, Haggerty with it
here. Getting those little skips. You're going to see it's get that little skip right before it gets to the keeper. And that's enough to cause him to spill the ball out. And luckily, Hurd's there to clean it up.
Craig Hurd, 50th minute of play, able to make it. A 2-0 lead here.
So Saints getting that early goal that we had talked about just a couple minutes ago that's going to be so crucial for them.
And now Erie really going to have to stretch themselves to get back into this one.
Have to worry, though. You always hear that saying, two-goal lead
two
is goal the most
lead.
Dangerous
You know, I
lead
grew up playing hockey where the two-goal lead was absolutely deadly.
Yeah.
If you had a two-goal lead, you almost always blew it.
Yeah, and the Saints, with their tendency for taking their foot off the gas, this is going to be a little bit of a concern. So we want to see them continue pushing, conserve some of that energy, though. We don't want to overstretch ourselves and hopefully hang on to at least some sort of lead.
Saints able to fight for the ball and keep possession here as it's Hanbury fighting for it. Just a bull in the china shop when he's running through that midfield there. Just burling over people. It stays here. Campos playing it back. Solomon now it's played up. Here's Campos. Flick on. This will be offside, though. And there goes the whistle. Great little exchange there, little pass back and forth from Erie, but Saints fortunate to get the offside call.
So Saints in control. They have a little bit of the luxury of being able to take some time, hopefully burn a little bit off the clock.
Here on the restart here, throw, putting it in. Is Williams. It'll be played back to him. He'll just boot this one out.
So I expect in the first half we saw a lot out of the Commodores with that long ball. We saw them look for trying to connect up top with Luca Campos and Danny Deacon. And I would expect now in a two-goal hole that we're going to see a whole lot more of that. Expect the Commodores to just keep dumping it right one.
So that ball gets sent out of the area. That'll roll down the hill. Someone will have to go chase that down. I see McKenzie getting on his horse. He'll be able to get to that by the end of this match.
Mm-hmm.
This substitution here coming for Erie. Number 27.
Looks like
Jake Duska coming in. See who's coming off here. Looks to be number 7.
Mitch Kavlik.
Yeah, Mitch Kavlik coming out.
Duska actually an Ohio State player.
Yeah, Ohio State product. There's
a little bit of a connection.
It's actually a few players on this Erie side that played their college ball in the state of Ohio.
Mm-hmm.
A couple Case Western players. This Erie still battles for this. Finally, it's knocked away. It was, I believe it was Heard there. And yeah, it looked like it was Cottrell that just went down in a heap there, favoring his right knee.
We've seen him grab at that a couple times this season.
Diley here. So we start back up. Up to Hurd. Hurd fighting for it. Gets it over. Great job there to get it over to Ryan Hanbury, who gets through his defenders momentarily, but coughs it up then. And they're going to call that on Hanbury, it looks like. And this may be a card upcoming.
Yeah, and you're going to see a replay of that here. Hanbury just getting a little over-exuberant in this tackle after he got dispossessed. And you can see him just go in there a little too hard, clean through, and earn himself that yellow.
Looks like they're going to make Erie redo that kick. His ref was still talking with Hanbury when they went to take it. So now Erie's ready. Everyone's ready on the free kick here. They're waiting for it still. And now the ref's ready to go.
Kind of odd to see Erie play short in that situation when we've seen them go long so often tonight.
Yeah, Sten Markson there, kind of moving it forward there. Now played back by Lund.
So Erie saw most of the possession in that first half, dictated a lot of play.
Yeah, they're going to try to move this forward here. That's Duska playing it in. Wiggum gets to it. Diley clears it out. Now Jake Duska with it again. Again, Ohio State product. He was looking for those guys from some of the bigger schools to show out. That ball will just go for a goal kick.
Yeah. So the Saints really, this is one of those examples of where they're going to find themselves in a position a lot of the game from here on out on their back foot, trying to adjust, trying to defend. You can see even when they were able to get that clearance out, it's falling right to a sea of blue shirts. So it's going to be a struggle for them. If they're not able to hold on to the ball, find some possession, they're going to find themselves pretty much constantly trying to adjust and wearing themselves out.
Good flick on header by Best and Hurd tracking there, forcing the clearance out to the side, throwing here. It'll be Best to take it. He'll play this up to Hurd. Hurd trying to get around his man. He does, but the ball doesn't. This will just be played out. Christian Mighton trying to pull some kind of volleyball move. And now it's Diley. Throw this wide here. Tried to get it to Hanson, overcooked it a bit, and now Erie has it. It's Solomon. He'll play it out wide. That's Tom Davis. And remember, he is sitting on a yellow. This play is all the way up. Saints kind of leaving some gaps there. Haggerty able to get in the way of that, and he'll try to check this one down as well. Cottrell, he tried to get a foot onto it. Now Cottrell will get to this one. He'll send it up for Anderson, who slipped momentarily. And now it's up for Hurd, pinged away, though. And Erie, they'll try to move back on the counter here. Going to play it up. It's Tony Wiggum fighting for it, and he'll be able to get to it, and he sends this thing all the way down the other end.
Better response there from the Saints. Also looking at seeing, actually it looks like Hurd's dipping a little bit further back into midfield, trying to create a little bit more space. He and Haggerty didn't really get the combination play going last half. Looks like by staggering them a little bit more, it's going to help the Saints out with that midfield area.
This ball is going to fall, but it'll be offside. It's really a great opportunity by Danny Deacon. Product from Sheffield, England. One of the many Mercyhurst University players on the side here. Dan Williams, again, he'll get ready to kick this away. It's actually just going to play this up a little bit. So get to play it up there from where the offside was at. Gets it to Diley. Diley sending it up the middle there. Picked off by Da Silva and cleared out. This will fall to Thomas.
There's another fluff clearance from Thomas.
Yeah, and this is going to leave the man wide open. And Dan Williams does a great job sliding there. He had a little bit of trouble too, so we've seen both keepers having trouble to kind of grasp that ball as it's rolling on the wet surface there.
Yeah, that's right.
Saints able to pull a goal out of their situation.
Williams somehow able to
He almost looked like a hockey goalie on the ground, kind of just trying to lay on the ball. Free kick here, taken immediately by the Saints. It's Diley over to Best. Best under a lot of pressure, had to play it back. Now Hurd. Hurd just trying to flick it on, and now he gets it back from Cottrell, and that'll go out.
Good ball from Cottrell there. Just didn't look like Hurd had read the interplay.
Haggerty running up, trying to put some pressure on. Now he's going to try to put some pressure on the keeper as well, as it was a back pass. He couldn't handle it.
Saints again suffering. We're not able to clear their lines, not able to hold possessions, and seeing a lot of guys like R.J. Best are having to cover a lot of ground as they get into these counter situations.
Here's Deacon out wide. Great pass from Duska. Now he'll play it up over the middle. Falls in, and then it's shot, and that go out. The whistle came beforehand.
You know, near side linesman had his flag up for offside.
Yep, the far side,
and it looked like it was actually Solomon who may have drifted just a bit off on the cross. Erie coaching staff not at all happy with their players for drifting off in that position. You understand that. They were pretty close to the end line there. It's not a whole lot of room to actually be in an offside spot.
Looks like Erie might be bringing Manny Sear into the match here momentarily as he starts to get himself set up there on the Erie bench. But here comes Erie now with it. Great ball played in. Almost found the Erie attacker, but falls to Wiggum. Kind of deflected off of Thomas, off the back of his feet as he was tracking back. And now here comes the other way. It was Haggerty fighting for it.
That was a great tackle there from Davis. Able to get down.
Now Erie with it again. It's Solomon. He gets it back. Give it to Ott. Back to Solomon. Ott with it now. Good ball played up. Duska thought he was offside, so he stopped for a moment there. Not able to get onto the end of that one. Erie, though, still moving forward here. Deacon.
Talking about forwards dipping far back. Deacon, about 30 yards now off that top line.
Yeah, really dipping back there. As Solomon moves up, looking for a pass. Now Solomon stays with it. Erie still being able to hold possession here as Saints kind of trying to scramble. Play on, says the ref, as Cottrell's going to just send this up, finding Hansen. Hansen coming with it now. He's got Hurd on the other side. Hansen going to try to dip around, get to it. He sends it in, and it goes just wide as it flashes across the goal mouth.
Not sure if the keeper got a touch on that, and actually skirted out. Looks like they're going for a goal kick.
Yeah, big goal kick here.
Good counter there from the Saints as they work that ball into that wide position. You like to see them find that man up high as they try to work it out of the back quickly after winning possession.
And now we will see Manny Sear entering the game. Manny Sear from the Ivory Coast. So Manny Sear comes in for Jared Ott. Ott out of the game. A restart here. Rolls ball back to Markson. Sten Markson sends it over. Out to Shager. Gets it up that far side there. Erie looking to get back into this one. This ball's going to fall to Tony Wiggum. He'll just kind of slow things down as he lets guys get forward. Now Cottrell. Tried to get around his man. He'll have to track back, get that ball. He does. Send up to Haggerty. Haggerty couldn't hang on to it. Wins it back, though. Haggerty not afraid for the physical play. And then ball sent up to Mark Hansen, but just could not find him. It'll be throw in here for Erie. No, it'll be Saints ball.
Not a whole lot of action on the Saints bench at the moment. One player up, not really moving around much.
Justin Smith kind of just standing there.
You have to wonder if Coach Wall is going to try to make these substitutions when the Saints kind of find themselves in a position where they've got heavy legs at the end of most of these games where they've conceded these late goals.
Now Saints do play again on Sunday, so that will factor in. No travel involved, but they'll be right back here. We won't have that on ICRC. But, again, that's you play these weekends where you play two matches. I know talking to the guys last week, it did play into how they did substitutions. They wanted to save some fresh legs for FC Indiana. They saw that as an opportunity to get points on the road. It did work out for them.
Yeah, they'll be facing a road-weary team this Sunday as well when the Minnesota United reserves, the NASL team's second team, will be in town. Great tackle there from Wiggum.
And now Duska trying to get it over. Picked off there. It's Tony Wiggum sending it out.
Hanbury a little concerned with the kick that he got there from the recent substitute.
Yeah, Manny Sear, I think he also might have had an infraction on Tony Wiggum. He was also throwing his hands up a moment earlier. And Diley, he's just going to play this up as Saints have really collapsed into their own end. No pressure up front for the most part as Hurd isn't even past the halfway line there.
Saints happy to sit back, try to defend this. They do have that lead to work with.
Two-goal lead to work with, but again, this is a team that's looking to get some wins.
Yeah.
They were falling in really some tight matches on the road where you thought, hey, maybe we could have done something. And then you had, of course, last week, we talked about it, one that's going to really stick in their craw for a while.
Mm-hmm.
This ball goes all the way back, tracking back to get it is Ryan Lund.
Yeah, and last week's match should serve as a warning, too. Not only did they have the goal advantage at that point, but they also had a man advantage and managed to concede three. So you have to worry in a situation, even with two goals, that something like that might happen again if they lose some concentration.
Here's Haggerty trying to steal it back. Best is going to play it up to Hurd, who just could not get a foot on it.
Almost a ballet.
Mason
move.
Still fighting for, excuse me, Hansen still running up for it. Giving a lot of pressure there.
Saints picking and choosing times when they do apply that eye pressure. It's paid off in RJ Best's case. Hansen nearly found himself something there too.
Yeah, Hansen really almost had a chance to steal that ball away and make this what you would think would be a three-goal lead and an insurmountable one.
So
Erie looks to be getting to make another substitution. Again, Saints bench We got two up stretching. It's Mighton and it's Justin Smith. Christian Mighton, Justin Smith. Mighton more of a winger. Smith, he may come in. He may come in for James Thomas, mm-hmm. and Hanbury might move back on that defensive line. That was a possible move. As this comes screeching across the goal mouth, it's played again. Duska able to keep things alive. He'll send it back.
Saints scrambling
Sten.
There on
yeah,
defense.
Saints really caught
there,
off guard there. As I was saying, though, Justin Smith possibly in for Thomas, moving Hanbury back. That was possibly what we could have solved if Thomas couldn't go tonight. That was the backup plan. This ball falls, and it is hit a mile into the air.
Yeah, it looks like it caught a little bit of
Hanbury. Yeah, caught a little bit of Hanbury there. It'll be corner upcoming for Erie as they continue to apply a little pressure here.
Yeah, that's where that concern we were talking about with the Saints just a little bit ago. It looks like they just lost some concentration, kind of scrambling in the back, trying to keep the ball out.
Corner comes in, punched out by Williams. Great job. He is not afraid to get out there and punch that ball. Some keepers aren't really into that, aren't really into punching that ball and getting yourself out there in dangerous areas.
Yep.
He is not afraid of it at all. This will fall right to Wiggum, who's looked to tee it off, but he'll just send it up to Haggerty.
Not much in that. I'm going to disagree with the referee pulling a card here.
Yeah, that'll be a yellow now on Hurd. Really looked like a 50-50 challenge.
Yeah, Hurd, actually, I'm pretty sure he won the ball in that situation as well. It's just the momentum that the Erie player had in that situation kind of forced him to tumble over.
Yeah, it was Ryan Lund was the one that went down there. So, yellow card for Hurd. You do have Christian Montoya on the bench. Tied with Haggerty as the leading scorer of the Saints. He is an option to come on. David Glatt, another option, a guy who hasn't really seen much time here. As a free kick comes in. It's a pretty good one, but Williams is going to punch it out. And they're going to call offsides.
And this was something we saw Coach Howell get a little angry with his players about earlier when they're in those advanced positions being offside when there's really not even room to be offside. Can't imagine he's pleased with that one either.
So we're going to get a substitution here. It again is going to be Erie making that move. Looks like it's going to be Austin Solomon coming out. Coming in is number 17, Joe Korb. Again, another member of that Mercyhurst side playing in the area there. That's brought them so many products. Luke Maitland about ready to check in for the Saints as well. We'll see if he comes in for Hurd or for Haggerty. Don't see Christian Montoya moving around. He's still on the bench. So it'll be Maitland coming in. It'll be a question as to where he goes. You'd imagine up top. Obviously the Saints concerned with Hurd. This game becoming physical. Don't want to go down a man. Here comes Erie though. Building pressure as they move up. We'll send this ball deep, but it'll go right to Dan Williams. He didn't even move his feet. RJ Best fighting for this one. He goes down. It'll just be a free kick, no card. And now we'll see the substitution. Yep, and it will be Hurd coming out for Luke Maitland.
And in the game, number 6, Luke Maitland. Replacing number 21, Craig Hurd.
So a good performance for Hurd, getting that second goal for the Saints.
Luke Maitland from Luton, England. Played at the University of Kentucky. One of the newer players that was brought in. Showed up for tryouts. He was one of the players that I know Coach Wall was excited about in preseason. It's one of the new toys to work with there in his attacking front there. Because now it's Erie kind of breaking the other way.
And they are clearly in space.
And this is going to be clearly in.
And great come out by Williams.
Defenders stop. Williams with a great stop there. This ball will trickle all the way out. It'll be a throw-in upcoming. Everybody stopped. because they saw that Manny Sears was offside, so they just all stopped thinking, hey, we don't have to play it. Manny's offside, stop moving, and then, my goodness, there you go. That was nearly a goal.
Yeah, and you could see the Saints players irate with the referee for allowing that to play on. The call that he's giving there is obviously that
Manny didn't factor in.
Yeah, that he was actually out of play, and you could see the Saints arguing, hey, you know, we were actually paying attention to him. He was affecting plays.
He was who we were chasing, and we stopped moving when he gave up on the ball. Erie's still with it, though. Play continues. This Erie player kind of just went down. I don't know if he lost his feet or
took
a hit there.
I think Campos went for a failed back heel there.
Yeah, he hit the deck there. This is going to go all the way back out. Erie's still with it, though. Putting a lot of pressure on here as it's Jake Duska. Saints able to win it back. Mitch Diley, he'll just send this up. You got Luke Maitland, a big guy, Luke Maitland.
Yeah, but he's not necessarily going to be the guy that's going to be moving to get open for those balls. He's more of a target player in a traditional sense. He's going to be a guy backing up in defenders, not necessarily someone that's going to be tracking down those long balls.
Probably the tallest player outside of the keepers on the Saints team. So this ball comes in. It's going to fall for Duska. But they're actually going to call Manny Sear offside. That's Manny Sear really struggling to stay onside here. It's not helping. Yeah, it almost helped at one point there a moment ago. It almost helped their attack as he led the Saints on, thinking he was offside. But
adequate distraction that time, but this time caught out of bounds.
Saints just still looking to kind of get back possession. We're at 70. Fourth minute of play here.
Erie's still in control.
Yeah, really in control so far in the second half.
You can see what they've been trying to do all half. They're trying to work it down these wings, look for dangerous balls across, both through the cross, and then try to find a man in the middle for an easy dart.
Now it's Maitland. He gets it from Haggerty, who picked the ball off there. Maitland kind of just holding up here so guys can get back, but this will go out. Be a throw in here for Erie. Maitland slow up to his feet. Guess he didn't expect that throw in to happen right away. Obviously, Erie looking to get the ball back into play, get up the field. It's Campos. Plays it over. Duska's going to send this in.
Wigan just got
that'll go out.
Enough of a touch, but looks like it might have still gone off the Erie player.
Yeah, it's goal kick. I thought I heard it deflect off of Tony Wiggum, apparently.
Maybe there were a couple deflections in there.
Ref felt that Erie touch at last, and here's Dan Williams. Firing it forward. Flicked on by RJ Best. Maitland doing his best to try to chase it down.
We really just need the Saints to settle the ball a little bit here. Make Erie work. Try to work them around, tire them out, get them in a position where. And there's a beneficial foul there, a little friendly from the referee.
Yeah, nice little freebie there from the ref to give a very generous call.
Ryan Hanbury not quick at all to get it back up.
Nope, and now Cottrell, he'll just pop this over to Bess. Now Maitland.
And it's faster play there from Dylan. You can see
Dylan
he caught himself in a
ball,
bad spot.
There. Now here's Deacon trying to get around Tony Wiggum. Couldn't lose him. He'll have to send it over to Duska, who sends it in. James Thomas all over that one as he clears it away.
Thomas not seemed to feeling any heavy legs.
Back this ball is in.
Back and groin seem to be doing okay here in the early stages after the
long
layoff.
He's still around.
Halftime.
We're at 76 minute of play.
Showing that old man grit.
Best going to try to track this down. Almost lost his head there. He had to duck out of the way of that. Is now Diley. Up to Hanbury. Hanbury played well tonight.
Yeah, big game for him.
Haggerty with it. He had Maitland off to his left. But he wanted to keep it going. He earns the free kick here.
Yeah, he had some heat in the midfield from two Erie defenders, and you're going to see
they really just closed in on him.
See a replay of that here, and he just felt that heat. He kind of slowed down his play a little bit and allowed the Erie defenders just kind of bowl him over. And it's a smart play. It allows us to eat up a little bit more time, allows his teammates to catch a breather.
Trell stands over this one. He's going to play this out wide to Hansen. It'll be way too much. So this will just be a goal kick. Tan Mudd's looking for that ball as that one goes bouncing away.
You know, I know we've got a lead to work with here, but the Saints have been incredibly wasteful tonight with those set pieces. That's probably the third or fourth one we've seen them directly give back to the other team
here
by just knocking it out of bounds.
Deep ball in. Erie sticking with their plan all night. Just bomb that ball forward.
Yeah, route one, definitely the only route on their minds for a majority of the evening. It's kind of odd. They're a team that's got the technical skill to actually play through the midfield, but they normally opt to just go long.
Sear playing it back to Shager. That just falls back to Tony Wiggum. Cottrell doing good spin move. Fight off that heat. Maitland's going to be offside on this one. This ball go out. Christian Mighton going to check in here, see who he comes in for. It's going to be Bast or Hansen. Well, it looks like they were going to make a change. Still waiting to figure out which player it was? No, they're going to wait here as they're trying to figure out the substitution situation. And now
looks like R.J. Bast is making way for Mighton.
R.J. Bast coming out. Good night from him.
Yeah, great night from R.J. Bast. That hustle goal that he gave us in the first half, really against the run of play. The Saints had been in the hole all evening, and he bailed them out by just putting that extra pressure on the defenders and the goalkeeper, and it earned them what may very well end up being the winning goal.
Toby Oyelea. About ready to check in here. See. Refs here really making sure the guys are wearing pennies even while they're waiting to check in. So,
not realizing that obscures our view as well.
Real by the book here. Oyelea just kind of had his around his neck. It was Ricardo da Silva that came out, so that ends the Portuguese's night. Erie's still with this. They fight to get a goal and get themselves back in this match. 79th minute of play here. Saints are kind of content to collapse in and just see this one out. Sten going to send it out long. Great job by Henderson to get to it first, and he'll stick with this here as him and Hansen try to clean things up. Henderson almost kind of getting himself caught out, though. And now he's the one kind of moving up with the ball.
And here's what we're going to want
to
see.
Up to Maitland. He went down. Maitland taken down again.
You just really want to see more out of him in that kind of situation. Big man playing hold as on, a target. Yeah. Want to see him hold up that play, give his teammates time to actually catch up to him, and he
looks like he's just been quick to go down these first couple moments. He's been in those opportunities.
Yeah, not sure if he's aware. He's a pretty big boy. The referee usually isn't going to give you those kind of calls in that situation.
Good ball picked off there by Mark Hansen.
Hansen, much better performance here in the second half himself.
And Maitland's offside there. Track back to get it.
And that's just some lack of awareness there, too. So just more effort out of Maitland. Already has his hands on his hips.
Here he's got a little under 10 minutes left, plus whatever stoppage time we'll get. At the moment, I can't believe it's too much. Obviously, we have all the substitutions that you get in the second half in an NPSL match.
Probably a minute or two at least at this point.
Sten over to Duska. Duska's going to send it in.
And Duska's had some opportunities to put
in dangerous balls
there, but he's just his crosses have been wanting.
And once again,
the
there's Campos, another Erie player in the box, offside.
That's probably their fifth or sixth offside here in the second half. Erie just indisciplined in keeping behind their markers, making sure that they're making that run a little bit earlier, a little bit later, or actually playing the ball a little bit quicker.
Williams, kind of a low liner, sending it forward. Maitland not able to get to it. Now Mighton fighting for it, but goes off him. Duska will throw it in right here. Duska on the quick throw-in. Tried to find Sears. Diley picked it off.
Diley's had a solid game this evening, his night tonight as well.
Fighting for it, Mighton and Sear. Then Haggerty just comes in and steals it. Now Haggerty. Well, he's got a little bit of space. He can play it up to Hansen, and he will. Hansen with some room out there on the far side.
Good fight in.
Going to try to cut in. He'll take a shot. And again, I don't know if he was trying to find Maitland there, but he sends it across the mouth of the goal again.
And that shot ends up going out for a throw in.
Yeah, it'll be a deep throw in here for Erie.
Almost had the much vaunted and very rare goalkeeper throw in there for a moment.
I know you're a big fan of those.
I love them.
Hanbury settles this one down. Back over to Mitch Diley. Over to Wiggum. He'll send it up. Tried to find Haggerty. He's going to fight for it, and he's won it. Won it off of two defenders. He'll play it over to Hansen and head upfield.
Haggerty looking inspired the last couple minutes. Good work in the midfield, providing for his teammates, setting up chances, and has created a couple opportunities for the Saints here.
This ball goes all the way back to Dan Williams. He's got a little bit of pressure. Can't get too cute with it. Now Diley up to Mighton. Mighton and Duska. Now Ryan Hanbury. He'll send it up.
And another great long diagonal. And
Mark Hansen's on.
Late call from the referee, and it didn't much matter. His Hansen shot went over the bar, but
Hansen looked on that.
You know, I'm just not going to agree with that call. I think the linesman just took his eye off of the players for a moment and assumed the jump that he had on that far side was the reason why he was actually in offside position. I think he was even. But you like that ball from Hanbury. That's the third or fourth time we've seen him hit that here today. Really opens up play on that far side.
Here's Sten cutting in through the middle. He'll play it over. Cottrell almost got it. Now goes off to the far side. Play it into the middle. Now Campos. Tried to get around Mighton. Mighton able to get the ball out of play. Good tackle there by Mighton. Throw in here. Duska. Luke Maitland getting in the mix as he got in the middle of that one. But it fell to an Erie player. And now this is sent in. Diving to a ball that never came was Dan Williams.
Some kind of slapstick defending from the Saints. But unfortunately, Erie whistled for the foul as they kind of played a little too rough there. Upended what looked like. And it looks like it's Haggerty that got tripped up there.
Yeah, it was Haggerty that went down. Here's Hanbury bombing it forward. Mighton's going to fight there to get it. It goes out of play. Throw in here for the Saints. 84th minute of play. Justin Smith looking like he's going to check in here momentarily. Maitland throws this one in. Mighton fighting with Duska. Fighting with Sten, plays it back to Luke Maitland. That ball goes out. Are they going to say that's Erie ball?
Not so sure about
that one. Saints bench not happy about that one.
The Erie bench here just a moment ago protesting to the near side linesman why he's been putting up his flag so often. Starting to wonder if they're actually getting some offside calls that aren't accurate.
86th minute of play here. Campos going to play it up to Duska. This ball's going to fall nicely to Duska. He'll play it in. But it goes straight to Tony Wiggum.
Another wanting cross from Duska there.
Yeah, kind of. His crosses have kind of been behind the man that he's trying to play.
Yeah, he's had the opportunity and had plenty of good looks and even time to get those
plays.
This
is going to fall to Manny Sear. Sear's going to track this down. He's got James Thomas. They fight over it, and it'll be a goal kick.
Thomas getting an enthusiastic slap of approval.
All right, so here's the substitution. We'll see what this ends up being. And it actually looks like it's going to be Haggerty coming out for Justin Smith. So Haggerty really does a straight-up midfield swap. We thought we might have saw that being the move that got James Thomas off the field. Obviously, he came into this match with some injuries. Question whether he not. He was even going to start. It would have been Justin Smith in the holding mid, Ryan Hanbury playing back where Thomas would have been on that back line.
Yeah, so a little bit more of a defensive move there by Coach Wall. Yeah. Bring in who's a guy who's traditionally a holding midfielder, putting him in that advanced role. Hopefully going to try to clog things up a little bit and halt some more of these Erie attacks.
Erie with it now. They'll play this one in, and it goes straight to Williams. Once again, Williams really not having to make much movement to get there as he's all over that one.
Yeah, he's not been forced to make any of his trademark big saves tonight, even though he's capable of them. But he's been in the right spots at the right time and has come out off a couple good punches to clear his line. So another good night and goal for Williams.
Saints looking for just their second shutout of the season.
Heard goalkeeper coach and assistant coach Jamie Starr there asking for the shutout there.
He wants the shutout.
As a former goalkeeper himself, you understand why he wants to see that so
this
much.
This is going to find Manny Sear, though. Sear and Thomas battling. Thomas got it out of there.
With a little under 5 minutes left to play, just a reminder, Jeremy and I have a podcast that we normally do, Wrong Side of the Pond. Check us out, wrongsideofthepond.com. Blog, website, National Soccer Pub Directory, anything you're looking for. WrongSideOfThePond.com and WrongSideOfThePond on Twitter.
Give us a listen and a follow.
Yeah, we'd appreciate it.
It'll be a throw in here for the Saints. Mitch Diley will take it. Saints again looking to start to ice this one here, 88th minute of play. This will go up. Luke Maitland's going to scrap for this one. He doesn't win it. And it's going to be Ryan Hammer just putting a foot on it and sending it upfield.
Maitland not happy with the hands he was getting.
Maitland not afraid to protest when he feels wrong. This kind of falls to Manny's. Decent opportunities. And then we had a little banana peel slip there. And now it's Mark Hansen off to the races.
He's all by himself.
Hansen's got Maitland coming up.
Maitland not really even making any effort at all to get into the box, into a position where he can help Hansen out.
Yeah, Maitland sort of just jogging. And for a guy who came on as a substitution, you would figure he's got the legs to see this one out.
Maybe he doesn't.
So an opportunity goes to waste there as Erie now bombing it back down the field. Manny's going to get to this one. Tip there and taken well by Dan Williams. Just so comfortable to get out there and try to control the ball with his hands.
Yeah, just on the edge of his box, you worry he might, spill that out or even exceed outside the limits of where he's allowed to touch it with his hands. And just a calm little tip over the on-rushing Campos.
Ball goes out. Throw in for Erie. They want to take it right away. Erie currently 3-0-3 on the season. 6-2-6 last year. Again, that was back when they were the Erie Admirals.
That's right. Erie also has a
different
little
color scheme and everything.
Yeah, that's right. They have a little bit of a history as the Erie Admirals as well. In their inaugural season in 2009, they made the national NPSL final. They've made it to the actual semifinals three times. So they've had some history, but not really had any good recent success.
Erie looking to take this throw in. They finally get it in.
And we're about to tip over here just now into the 91st minute. Haven't yet seen the fourth official.
Yeah, we've
signal how much extra time we're going to see.
We've hit 90 minutes. And now here, Erie, an opportunity on the far end. This ball will be played in. It flashes across the goal mouth. Diley almost threw a boot on it that could have possibly cost the Saints a goal there. Dan Williams was touch late to track back to it.
And I think I just saw the referee signal there's going to be 2 or 3 minutes of added time. So just a little bit more time here for the Saints to try to hold on to what will most likely be a win, hopefully even a clean sheet.
This ball will roll up to Mudd, who under a little bit of duress, Maitland charging in on it, kind of sends it straight up in the air. Didn't get it downfield as far as he wanted to. Now Justin Smith fighting for it. He's taken down. They say play on. And now some real extracurriculars coming at the end of that one.
Yeah, and I'm actually shocked that the referee allowed that to play through there. Number 17 for Erie, Joe Korb, just went in, totally studs up. The referee put his whistle to his mouth like he was going to call and actually let it play on, and it just really got under the skin of the Saints players there. Almost resulted in a little melee.
Yeah, Justin Smith not happy at all to not get a whistle for being taken down in that regard. Here comes Erie. And he's here playing it back.
Goes
starting
down
to see some slipping now here late on. This is going to be played over to Mark Hansen.
Really like
he'll
to
be
see
good
Hansen
to just take
just
this to the corner.
Hold on to the ball here. No reason to rush this thing.
He earns the throw in. Saints will slowly trot downfield. Some of them not even giving it that much of an effort as they don't really care to see this throw in happen anytime soon. Throw in finally happens. And we'll get the call down there.
Saints doing their best to try to kill the clock over in the corner.
So it'll be a free kick here for the Saints.
Expect them to play it short here. And
yeah,
hopefully keep it in that corner space. Try to battle it off. We can't have much more than a minute or so of added time left. Just a couple of the Saints players over asking the referee how much time is left. And here we see them play it here short.
Yep, just trying to keep it in the corner. It'll eventually go out. Erie ball. It's Luke Maitland, I believe it was, just kind of slowly getting up there.
Yeah, staying in the way as long as humanly possible. And a pretty
Gary
handy.
Henderson doing a great job getting to that ball, though. Yeah, this theory side has been pretty handsy most of the night.
Mm-hmm. Want to see the referee kind of take this thing by the reins at the end. Don't need to see any late injuries in a match that's already sewn up.
Saints and Erie battling for it on the far end there. Erie desperately wanted to get forward, and it falls. That was James Thomas just hoofing it forward as much as he could. And that's it. Saints take this one. Clean sheet for Dan Williams, his first of the season. Goals in the 39th minute by Best and the 50th by Hurd. That is the difference. It's the second shutout of the season for the Saints. As they get their third win. All three wins coming at home. Lindsay Patterson down on the sideline. We'll send it to her.
At Winthrop High School starting at 2 p.m. this Sunday. Of course, fans, you can also follow on the team on the
It looks like we're having some more technical difficulties.
Follow at Cincy Saints and
with her equipment there.
Underscore Saints to get all the latest news on the teams.
Sure, Coach Dave Wall, happy to get the result, turn the tide. It's been a rough few weeks for the Saints.
Yeah, the Saints
dropped some bad results.
Yeah, the Saints have really not put together a very good run of form, and this is hopefully something that's going to set them off in the right direction. You know, not exactly the most dominating performance from the Saints. Didn't see a whole lot of the ball, but what they did do was come out, fire up, apply some pressure at the right times, and actually be able to steal all 3 points, even in a game they didn't control.
Saints heading over and cheering on the supporters that did make it out tonight. Of course, severe weather in the area. We saw the delay that we had. But that'll do it for us. Saints' next broadcast will be their last. That'll be the end of the season against the Indiana Fire. That's how they'll close out the 2015 campaign. Again, it's Saints 2, Commodores 0 for Lindsay Patterson. DJ Schweitzer, our PA man, Don Shook.
Yes.
I'm Jeremy Lance saying good night, everyone.